Josette Frank Award, which honors a book of literary merit in which children or young people deal in a positive and realistic way with difficulties in their world and grow emotionally and morally. The 2013 Josette Frank Award goes to Wonder by R.J. Palacio, edited by Aaron Clark and published by Knopf Random House.
Thank you so much. I'm almost tempted to ask Marion to read my acceptance. because it was so, it's such a tough act to follow. I am truly honored and humbled to be receiving the Josette Frank Award and to be part of the stellar group of authors who've been singled out by Bank Street and the award committee for more than 70 years, 75 years. I was born actually not far from Bank Street, just a few more stops on the 2 train uptown in the Bronx. So there's something very special about being honored in one's hometown. I'm the daughter of two Colombians who loved books. When they came to this country in the early 60s, they didn't know any English. And in many ways, theirs was the typical immigrant story of working hard and making sacrifices so their children would have every opportunity in the world available to them. I wouldn't be here today if it weren't for my parents. Neither one of them went to college, though they were both the most well-read people I have ever known. I grew up in a house full of books. My father favored the classics, Dante, Pascal, Cervantes. Anything beyond Tolstoy was way too modern for his tastes. My mother, on the other hand, was much more of a 19th and 20th century gal. You know, she had a thing for German authors like Thomas Mann and Günter Grass and Heinrich Böll. She adored Oscar Wilde, Faulkner, and of course the Latin Americans, Garcia Marquez in particular, and Pablo Neruda. And that's where my parents did overlap. They fell in love, in fact, over the Ode to Elemental Things. I mention this all only because I'm standing here less than 3 miles away from where these two petite people came a little more than 50 years ago to start a life together. And since they themselves were both writers who never had the opportunity to really write, there's something kind of amazing in their daughter being here. So I stand here for them today. My mother especially, she was the one who would always tell me that I was going to be a writer someday. And I knew she was right. I knew that someday I would write. And of course, I wish she were here to have seen that she was right about that. But I guess in a way she is here. I took her last name as my pen name as a way to honor her and everything she did for me. When I started writing Wonder, I had no intention of writing a book that would receive any awards, to be truthful. I certainly didn't write it because I thought it would be a commercial or viable book. If anything, I knew a story about a boy with a severe craniofacial difference would be a tough sell. And I won't lie to you, there were times when I was writing it that I'd think to myself, I would make my life a lot easier if I turned Augie into some kind of vampire or with magical powers living in a dystopian future. But the truth is, I had a very simple story that I wanted to tell about an ordinary boy facing a world that didn't want to face him. I wanted to write a simple story about ordinary kids who rise to the occasion when given the chance. I wanted to raise the bar a little from what our expectations for kids this age seem to be to what those expectations could be, because I do believe with all my heart that kids have a capacity to be quite noble. I do believe that it's hard to teach empathy, but it's quite possible to inspire it. And I do believe that kindness can be nurtured as easily as it can be squelched in the young, but once it's taken root, it can never be extinguished. And I do believe in the inherent goodness of people, I really do. That's not to say the opposite doesn't exist in the world, but like the mother in the book, I really do believe the good far outnumber the rest, which is why we need to come together. As Marcus Aurelius said, quoting my father's favorite author, the world can be a single city whose citizens are united by reason and mutual affection. I wanted to write a story that would make kids united by reason and mutual affection. I couldn't have written this book without the inspiration given to me by my own children, Caleb and Joseph. I'm not saying they're perfect kids, because of course they're not, but they're such good eggs, and part of me wrote the book because I wanted the world to be as good a place as it could be for them. And maybe writing is a little bit about wish fulfillment. But when I have kids coming up to me now and telling me that they want to be kinder after reading my book, I'm reminded of a line I read once: to be kind is the greatest measure of human happiness. How great a thing it could be if this next generation knew and maintained that level of happiness. I couldn't have written this book, of course, without the love and support of my husband, Russell, who took my hand for the first time about 30 years ago and has never let it go. He was my first editor on the book, my truth-sayer, and my motivator, all rolled into one. And he also led me to my agent, Alyssa Eisner-Henkin of Tribe Media, who has been such a huge part of the success of this book. And of course, it was Alyssa who brought me to the team at Random House, including my editor, Aaron Clark, my publicist, Lauren Donovan, and the most supportive, smart, and brilliant group of people anyone could possibly hope for. I want to thank every one of these amazing people for all they've done for Wonder, not just for publishing and promoting the book, but for getting the message of choosing kind out there. I also want to send out a shout out to Jenny Brown and Lisa von Dresick, who I just met for the first time a little more than a year ago at that dinner that was organized by Random House. And so much has happened, but from the very beginning, they were such wonderful and beautiful champions for the book, and I'm so appreciative of it. Lastly, I do want to mention the kids I've met over the past year, and in fact, the original child who got me wondering in the first place, who struggle with the same issues as Augie struggles with in the book. Their stories have moved me, and I consider myself privileged, if it's true, that my book has made your lives one iota easier. I share this award with them because I really do believe they overcome the world and that they're all wonders. So thank you, everyone at Bank Street. I really, really appreciate this award, and I'm very honored. Thank you very much.